Hey guys, and welcome back. So it's been a couple weeks and a lot has changed in the modding community, and the biggest change is there's a mod that you can download that allows you to spawn raiders right outside a sanctuary. So ever since I discovered that, I decided to go pretty nuts when it comes to building inside Sanctuary, and as a result I have founded Sanctuary City. So this video will basically be a walkthrough of Sanctuary City. And then after that, it will be Sanctuary City Under Siege, where I will basically spawn a bunch of raiders, super mutants. We'll see, but I'll spawn a serious attack on my city. So if you guys are only interested in that, go to the description and click on the link that jumps straight to the attack. If you are interested in seeing Sanctuary City and what I built, then stick around. But we'll get to the attack eventually. So a couple things to note, I have several mods enabled, and many of them I had to use in order to optimize the game to make my city playable. And the same issue in Diamond City is an issue in Sanctuary City, where basically people with really high-end PC systems like mine, they just have poor performance in large cities. So I had to mod the hell out of my game just to make it playable. So if there is any choppiness, hopefully Bethesda will fix it, but it is totally expected because they just have not optimized the game for PC. I think it was a console port to PC, so they have some work to do there. Anyway, so without further ado, welcome to Sanctuary City. Ta-da! I've got a big-ass sign. That's right, a giant sign, which took a long time to build and has an awful lot of generators on the roof to power it. A lot of folks might ask, why? Why do this? You know, and my answer is, well, it's fun, and I've already beat the main quest line. End game? I don't know. I'd do anything.
Kill for a drink.
So, you know, this is what I built, and it's basically an expansion on what I already built. You can see I've got 1, 2, 3 guard posts there, a spotlight, and a heavy laser turret. I got rid of the old machine guns because they're not as powerful as these more optimized turrets. The spotlight increases the accuracy of the laser, the heavy laser, and I think it may increase the range because the spotlight can be set to target enemies. Yeah, and same thing over here. 3 guard posts, heavy laser with a spotlight. And in the middle, I don't have the spotlights, but I do have the 3 guard posts and the heavy laser. You move a little forward, you'll notice I've got an embedded guard post there and an embedded guard post there. So 8 guard posts? That's crazy! Yeah, maybe. We'll see how crazy it is once I spawn a ridiculous amount of raiders. Okay, so on the left here, we have a little lookout. Someone can sit here and watch the bridge. If they go up one floor, there's a siren that they can punch. Same thing on this side. This entire design is very symmetrical. So anything you see on the left is going to be on the right. Everybody suggested that I close off all the entrances to just a single entrance on the bridge, and I agree, it makes a lot of sense. So the only way in and out of Sanctuary City is through the bridge. And once you get across the bridge, you have to go through the gauntlet. Oh yeah. What is the gauntlet? And why am I such a nerd? I don't know, and the gauntlet is basically 2 missile turrets, 2 spotlights, and 2 shotgun turrets. That's right. So if they make it all the way down here, they're just getting blasted to hell. And so that's what the gauntlet is. Not a lot to say there. There's another missile launcher turret right there. So if they manage to get this far, they're probably going to breach the outer defense. And that's what this backup frontal defense is for, where I've got, looks like, about 5 to 7 guard posts, another spotlight, and 2 heavy laser guns. So let's go up here. Oh, let me show you this first. I basically just blocked off my generators and most of my generators from direct line of fire. So if they're trying to blow up my generators, it'll be a little difficult. Same thing on this side. Over here, not much has changed. Still have the artillery battery over here. I did add a spotlight to this side. And I think maybe a laser turret there. So that's just to check out what's going on this side, and it would target the enemy and then increase my turret's accuracy and range, I think. Okay, so let's go up here to the front defense. It's pretty much what, you know, I said earlier. It's just a bunch of guard posts, some sirens, a nice lookout access on the bridge. I do have dual ladders and stairs, like you'll see here, dual stairs for this guard post, dual stairs here, dual stairs there for this guard post, because the NPCs are just dumb and they get stuck. So that's why. The guy's got a nice sledgehammer. You will notice that I do have a settler soldier, which is a mod, and I decided to go with these because I wanted my city to feel more like Diamond City, and by doing so I needed kind of a canned soldier. It's also a hell of a lot easier just to spawn these guys because they have decent weapons and decent armor than having to manually outfit all of the settlers, which sucks. But you could do that. So we'll go up one floor. And up here we have a few beds for crashing and a ton of guard posts. That's basically what this third floor is about. And we've got a laser turret there. That's pretty much it for this floor. Let's go to the fourth floor and see what in the hell is powering this monolith. A shit ton of generators. That's right. That's what powers the light boxes and the Sanctuary City sign. We've got lookouts here. We have a siren for the lookouts. Access to the light boxes for the Sanctuary City sign. And over here we have a terminal which controls the lights. And I'll show you that real quick. Won't spend too much time on this. I'm sure most of you have used this before. But if you connect a terminal to an electronic device, usually gives you extra abilities. And for me, I just set the color to yellow. And I think I set it to yellow normal for the Sanctuary City sign. So you just do that. Once you see setting light color, you hold down tab and it backs right out of the console. Here is another access to the sign. Okay. So now I'm just going to drop down, hopefully not die. There we go. Save some time.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at the inn. So the idea behind the inn is when provisioners or supply lines come in through the gauntlet and they're not assholes and they're tired, they can stay at the inn where we have Class C coolant and Class A coolant, as well as a bar, some seating, magazine rack, water, you know, place to chill out, maybe play cards, sleep. These bums are already asleep. Poop, pee, you know, everything you need from an inn. That's the inn. The second floor of the inn is not accessible from the ground floor. None of the first floor buildings here can access the canopy. The canopy is pretty much the second floor and above. The idea behind that is if anyone was to breach Sanctuary City, breach the outer defenses, and get inside the city, they would have to breach the inner sanctum or the inner city in order to get to the canopy or the keep. So that's the keep. What is the keep? Last time in the previous video, I was telling you guys about the idea of having a keep where everyone could flee if the city was under siege. And that's what this is. It's just a ginormous building that you can only access once you get inside the inner city or the inner sanctum. And we'll go over that later. Here are the farms. The farms surround pretty much the keep's building. The first floor does not access the second or above floors. It is the farmer's lounge. So that's where all the farmers go to hang out, get a bite to eat, cool off from the hot day, you know, maybe play some pool, whatever it is. Whatever it is they want to do. Over here we've got some light boxes to showcase the full basketball court with bleachers. You know, there's some competitive gaming in the wasteland, and Since Bethesda only likes basketball at this time, that's what we've got. Over on the left, we've got a little kiddie basketball court and closer seating for the parents that need to help their kids make those baskets. So the shops are up here, but before we go to the shops, let's go down here to the Farmer Lounge. The Farmer Lounge has got some, you know, farm-inspired art as well as farmers. Farmers would hang out here, get a bite to eat, use the restroom, as you can see, men and women. So it's just the lounge. It's where they refresh. And they can go back out onto the farm and get back to work. Because everybody has to farm. This is the wasteland. And in the wasteland, everybody has to do their part. It's a team sport, or we all die. Okay. Now over to the shop. The shop. Well, I guess it's really shops, but whatever. This is where you shop. During normal operating hours, or hours of operation, these are all manned. So I've got one of each. Everything you could possibly need. It's right off the main road where the provisioners hang out and bring their Brahmins. Over here we've got Dog Meat in his doghouse, just making sure shit's not getting out of control. Dog Meat's always around to just fuck shit up if it gets out of hand. Best dog in the world. Got a cooking station. Most of the first floors of these buildings have nothing in them. No one really lives in those homes. They all live in the keep or the guard homes. So we'll go inside the inner city or the inner sanctum later. For now, let's check out this bend. This is where everyone goes at night when they want to have some fun. I go to the hive. And of course, with any great establishment, we need some dumpsters. And here are the dumpsters. Over on the left, we've got some basketball goals, some radio playing, and some cigarettes and trash and cola, what have you. So the hive is where people go to hang out. You know, I wanted to have something like this, because Diamond City has something like this. And what is it? It's a few things. I'll show you. Let's stop talking. It's a bar. It's got billiards, got a place to sit, smoke, lounge about, listen to the radio. First floor is mainly a bar. The second floor is more. It's a restaurant. It's a restaurant, it's a dance hall. It's two different types of restaurants, really, but I'll show you. Here's the restrooms. Of course, you need to have restrooms. This is where you can show your best moves to the Wastelanders. You can hit the jukebox, grab some cola. This is where you'd sit down and eat a nice proper meal. This is where you get that food. Over here is the smoking section. We've got some ashtrays for the smokers. Let's say you have a date and you want to take on a romantic date. You take her to the hive, or him to the hive, and over here in the corner you've got a nice secluded area that has a great view of the wasteland, and you can get that fresh breeze coming in, that radioactive breeze, with classical music on the radio. The third floor of the hive is the lounge, or the movie room, where hopefully, eventually, actual video will play on these TVs, but the idea is it's kind of a movie theater. And that's the hive. A little bit of everything for everyone. All right, let's exit the hive, and let's go inside the inner city, or the inner sanctum. So the idea is that if the raiders make it in here, everybody needs to flee to the keep. But it's pretty well defended, so they may not breach the inner sanctum. So if you watched the last video, you're very familiar with this. You know about the boardwalk that goes all around what I call sanctuary proper. So I can show you this. I guess, you know, this will be review for a few of you. But this is the boardwalk.
Yes.
And I added this, I think, with a siren, but nothing drastically different from last time. Basically guard posts that surround, you know, sanctuary proper, as I like to call it. It goes all around and you can walk on the roofs too. We have some farms in here in case the outer farms are destroyed or raided. And let's say the boardwalk is lost and people breach this inner sanctum of the city. Well, guess what? There's still one place people can flee to, and that's the keep. So once you're up here, you can just keep going up the stairs to the top of the keep. Before we do that, I'm going to show you this area. This is the common area. This is the first floor of the keep, and it connects the sky bridge over there to the lookout over here to the boardwalk over there. Let's go to the lookout first. What is the lookout? It's a way to see the front of Sanctuary City while being within the keep's boundaries. So you can't access this from the inn, which is below it. The only way to access this is by getting inside the inner sanctum or the keep. So this is a way to see if someone's attacking, sound the sirens, and flee back to the keep. That's what the lookout is for. Okay. The common area here is a lot like the hive, but it doesn't have some of the cooler features of the hive. It's just, you know, people can get a lot of what the hive has to offer without, you know, getting killed by raiders. Here is the sky bridge, and the sky bridge leads over to the canopy. And I will quickly show you the canopy. Here is the light box terminal that controls the light boxes. Okay, so what is the canopy? The canopy is a series of guard posts that protects Sanctuary City. Let's say the raiders are on the main road. Well, I'm going to have soldiers on either the bottom or the top floor of the canopy attacking and sniping the raiders before they breach the inner city, which is just beyond near the shops. So this is all throughout, all around. Here's the canopy. There's one end of the canopy. And you could go on the bottom floors of the canopies as well, which contains usually chairs and just a vantage point to see what's going on. We'll go back over here, go to the bottom floor. Yep, there you go. We can get up this way. Here we are. So now we're on the other side of the canopy, and I'll just quickly show you this. I think you already have the idea. It's basically guard posts, soldiers. And if Sanctuary City is breached, there's a way to defend it and stop people from getting into the inner city or the inner sanctum by just getting on the canopy and shooting them from these guard posts. So if you go up to the top floor over here, you will notice that there is access to what I like to call the guard quarters for the canopy. So if you're a guard on the canopy, you don't want to walk all the way back to the sky bridge. You can just hang out here and, well, it looks like some people are already sleeping here. So that's the sky, not the sky bridge, the canopy guard post sleeping quarters. Okay, so as you can see, we're about to go on top of the hive. The hive cannot access the canopy.
Smith, everybody.
There's the terminal, controls the light boxes for the hive. We've got some guards up here. Here's one chilling out over there, watching, making sure shit is in line. Let's go over here and go down there. And you guys will see that this connects to the boardwalk. All right. Finally, the last thing I'm going to show you is access to the keep. So let's say someone is running from the inner sanctum, from these farms, right up to the keep. They would go this way and up this ladder. And immediately, if a raider was doing this, they would see these turrets that would start attacking them. There is one, there's several around every ladder. Okay? So that's the first defense of the keep. Now let's say they get up all the way here. Now this is where you would, where the enemy would really get hit hard. Four turrets. And I have a little trap door that you could just put right on top of this and remove the ladders to make it really difficult for raiders to get up here. This is just a silly idea that I had. Of course, it doesn't exist in the game mechanics, but kind of cool that you could just plop that on top, remove the ladders, plop that on top. And then, of course, you also have a basketball court for kids. There's another guard post. Looks like the sun's coming up soon. All right, now this is the keep. This is the very, very top. It's the holiest of holies. If the enemy gets this far, everyone's dead. And as you might expect, what's up here is the sleeping quarters for everyone. It looks like a lot of people are asleep. And we even have cribs for the children. So the general idea is you... This is the safest part of the city, and this trap door would keep you really safe. They would have to somehow knock this off, get rid of or reapply the ladders, and breach these turrets. But if there was a raid, we would remove the ladders, put this on top, and have some relative safety, and you could just stay up in the keep until hopefully they go away. Probably just steal your food and water. The only other thing I was going to show you is this is on top of the sky bridge. We've got a couple guard posts on top of the sky bridge. And that might be it. Okay, guys, so if you're here to see Sanctuary City get attacked, you're in the right place. I summoned a couple things with this raider mod and a few manual placements of some ground troops. So let's see how Sanctuary defends itself. And I will try not to... get involved, just sort of watch. So enjoy, and I hope to see you in my next videos. Looks like the the soldiers defended very well from the canopy. Killed these behemoths very fast. And the siren went off as expected.
Thought I... Nah.
Someone help!
Something's up.
Oh no.
Well, that's weird. Came right through the wall. Looks like it took out my missile launcher. These are all turned around. Oh. I think I have to trigger this. The mod's a little buggy. Okay, here they come. Whoa. Oh, wow. Pretty serious air assault. Wow. The Brotherhood of Steel. I hope nothing crashes into the keep. Oh, my missile launcher shot at him. Some stuff's on fire. Well, it looks like the ground attacks just got destroyed really quickly. Whoa! Oh no! Oh god, they're going down! No, no, not the keep! Not the keep! Not the keep! Grr. Damn. Ah, the sign's still on. But the building is on fire. Oh no! Oh no! Not the generators! Shit! Alright, I've had enough of watching. It's time to take this one down. Not very powerful. Wow, blew that right out of the sky. Ooh, damn. How about a nuke? Yeah, these guys are bugged. They don't attack. I'll try toggling the AI on and off. See if it makes any difference. Nah, they're just bugged. That's too bad. That would have been kind of a cool attack right there. So, I mean, it seems like the city defended itself, especially from ground assaults, very easily. And unfortunately, this mod just...
German Chang will fall. China will fall.
Yeah, it's just... these guys get stuck. It's unfortunate. Like, what are these guys doing? They're just there. So this mod has some work that, you know, they need to work on that. Not sure how much they can do without, you know, getting the actual modding tools, because the pathing is all screwed up.
Come on! Let's go!
Oh no, not the keep! Oh man. Took out part of my sign too. Whoa. Get him, dog meat! Get him!
You hit like a rat.
Okay, I can't stand for this.
Stupid dog.
Die! Oh, shit. Oh, not the keep, not the keep, not the keep. Damn. Oh, my God. Oh, man. Everything's gonna be destroyed.